And we're back. Let's jump into this real quick because, again, I don't want to go too long. And the film is from 1997. Trying to give a brief recap. So we left off with John Seda, who plays J-Lo, Selena's husband, then husband. He's still alive, Chris Perez. He was already garnering a name for himself in the industry by the time he had done this 1997 film, Selena. But I know him best from the 1994 film, I Like It Like That. Very New York, very Puerto Rican. And not for nothing, you see a number of other Latino actors who star alongside him in that movie. And are still working to this day. Elvis Nolasco is one. He's gone on to work with Spike Lee and a number of other cast members on the show. Lauren Velez too. She's been, you know, really well known in the industry. But we see our like Latino actors cutting their teeth on those films to go on and do these incredible movies that I'm sure when they shot them, they were just like, well, it's a movie, but not knowing how relevant and how synonymous to pop culture they would become. So much props to John Seda. Also, we have from the cast Edward James Olmos, and he was already known. He was very established. I think he was one of the bigger names that they cast to play Selena's dad. Constance Marie. And Edward James Olmos, if you don't know, I mean, if you've been living under a rock, Stand and Deliver. He's done a number of films that, to this day, I'm very surprised that man does not have an Oscar. But nonetheless, he's one of our bigger ones, our big Latino representation actors. Lupe Antiveros, who played Yolanda Saldívar, who's the one that ended up killing Selena. She was an incredible actress, and I think we just lost her maybe a year or two before COVID, but she had a long trajectory in the film industry, and yeah, she had to pay her dues. And unfortunately for a lot of Latinos, you have to play maids and you have to play the babysitter, and you know, with the heavy accent, even though she spoke perfect English. But she was an incredible actress, she really was, and she did pull off Yolanda very well in this film. Constance Marie, who played Marcela Quintanilla, Selena's mom, incredible actress. And if the name sounds familiar, if you've seen the George Lopez show, she played George's wife on that show. We also have Jacob Vargas, who played A.B. Quintanilla. We have Jackie Guerrera, who plays Jose Quintanilla. We didn't know too much in terms of, like, who played, like, the band, because the concentration was more on the family for the film. But in the series, which is another set of young actors, you know, we have a better understanding of who all these other incredibly important people to Selena and how they played an incredible role in her life, in the essence, basically, her band. Because remember, it was Selena y Los Dinos. It had always been Selena y Los Dinos. It wasn't just Selena. Although the record company that she was signed to wanted to make it just Selena. And that's where you see that inner conflict come in for the series, because she, you know, she was like, this is my band. This will always be my band. It's my family. We're a whole team. It's not just me. They wanted to break that apart, you know. And they were like, you know, hey, they can always come back. But they wanted to try for her to do her crossover as a solo act. Also, important note, too, that from the cast, we have Sadie Lopez, who plays Deborah. Now, if you guys remember the scene where Selena, the very famous, beautiful white gown with the bejeweled and everything, where she gets her Latin Grammy, or Grammy at the time, she went shopping in a mall and wanted to get a very nice, you know, beautiful gown for her friend. They go to several hoity-toity shops and happens to, you know, go into one That, you know, was very kind of, you could tell that they were racist. They didn't want to treat them because they just saw two brown girls and they were like, well, they probably couldn't even afford these gowns. In fact, one of them tells her, like, oh, that's just too expensive. And she's like, that's not what I asked you. I was like, do you have this and do you have this size? So the girl that plays J-Lo's, well, Selena's friend in the show, is played, which is Deborah here, is played by Sadie Lopez. Now, the reason why I make mention of it is because she would go on and play the mom in the series. So everything's interconnected, which I love. And in the movie version, the dress did not fit. It was not even all that great of a color. She wanted it to fit, but once everybody started taking notice, like the boys in the stock room, because like I said, a lot of Latinos knew who she was. She just wasn't known mainstream because, again, if you were living in the United States, you were going to listen to Madonna and Jody Watley and In Vogue. But you know, rarely, if you were not in Texas or in Mexico, you really didn't necessarily know who she was, especially if you only spoke English. But if you spoke Spanish and you had those channels like Univision and Telemundo and Televisa, you knew who she was. Because I did. Sorry. Sorry, not sorry. I was a fan. But nonetheless, it was an incredible cast. I also want to make mention that Alamo Drafthouse, which we have a few here in New York, but Alamo took off in Texas, which is, again, where Selena is from, Corpus Christi, Texas. And so, and they have a number of museums and dedication to her. So Alamo Draft House has this beautiful dedication because they are streaming the film currently. And I recommend you go to an Alamo House. If you have not gone to an Alamo Draft House theater, you are missing out. Can't tell you how many, hold on a second. How many fun nights I've had at Alamo Draft House. I seriously recommend them. They have a great bar, incredible menu that often goes with the theme of the film. The waiters come to you like ninja style so they don't disturb your viewing experience. And you have these incredibly comfortable chairs with a nice little table. It is very reminiscent as if you were watching it at home, but you have the perk of having the silver screen in front of you, an incredible sound. So I believe there's one in Yonkers and there's one here in Brooklyn. I think they just opened one in Lower Manhattan. And I'm praying, because they've been at this for a very long time. I remember when they were just constructing the one in Yonkers, that's where I got my sticker from. And they gave us a whole tour and how they have private events. But they were in the midst of, I believe, they were going to try to move their business to 96th Street. So more or less Midtown, I guess I would say, but a little above Midtown. But 96th Street and Broadway. It used to be the famous Metro, and it was a movie theater for decades. I don't know if they were able to attain the landmark status, but it went through so much red tape and whatever, and that's why I think they ended up constructing their theater out in Brooklyn. But I think they got their footing back. So if you see it, the theater opening up on 96th Street here in New York, get yourself some tickets, because they really are an incredible experience, I will say. The one that I went to in Brooklyn was fabulous. But here's their letter that they have currently on their site, and I will link that information in the description box below. But isn't this incredibly beautiful? It says, feeling the beady beady bum bum at this interactive screening. Join us at the very special movie party as we celebrate the life and music of one of America's most beloved icons, Selena Quintanilla Perez. Sure, we could just sit quietly and watch the magnificent 1997 film Selena starring Jennifer Lopez and in a star-making performance, but we think the best way to honor Selena is to share in the joy of her music. Whether you want to sing along or use any of the fun props we'll have available, when you arrive, you are strongly encouraged to lose yourself in all of Selena's classic songs while you enjoy the film. So throw on a rhinestone bra. Oops, we mean bustier. Remember Busti Kaka? When her father saw her and all that get up, he was so mad. But anyway, that's a movie quote. And join us for a fun-filled night full of bitty bitty bum bum. About the movie party events, spanning all genres, Alamo Drafthouse movie parties are an immersive, interactive experience for cinema fans featuring fun props, themed drinks, and more. About celebrate the life and legacy of Tejano music star Selena Quintanilla with screening of Selena, the 1997 film written and directed by Gregory Nava and starring Jennifer Lopez in the true story of Selena Quintanilla Perez, a Texas-born Tejano singer who rose from cult status to performing at the Astrodome, as well as having a chart-topping albums on the Latin music charts. Selena left an indelible impression in the hearts of so many people. And for those of us at Alamo Drafthouse based in Texas, it's an honor and a privilege to be able to honor her legacy and celebrate her talent. Bravo! Bravo, Alamo Drafthouse. Again, I can't recommend them enough. If you have the chance, and again, if you're in the city, and I believe that they may be extending its screening because maybe in honor of her birthday. She was born April 16th, 1971. So again, this has been super fun. I had a blast putting this bustier together. I mean, just the fact that it had all these intricacies and all of this kind of design pattern, I give her much credit because this was very hard. For me, it was like, I don't know how she came up with this at 23, 20, 21, 20, 22, 23, because I wouldn't have necessarily thought of this pattern and the way that it drapes, and it's so her, you know. I think she was very, very intelligent and you know, she knew her shape very well. She knew what suited her, and for the time being and for the fashion that it was at that time, she was an incredible talent. And I'm not gonna lie, I've had a blast doing these. This was the first one that I was able, and again, I did this on my own. This was the first one I did. I'm gonna show off my work, sorry. Like, I'm not just gonna have them hanging and dangling or whatever. I wanna show off this one I did over the summer. These were like her classic looks. She had like, you know, a variety of bustiers, and this was like her famous, you know, she paired this with a nice, beautiful, you know, white jeans, and it looks nice. It really does. I mean, I know it looks like just like a bunch of bras with jewels on them, but they were really costumey. I think, honestly, she, and especially the fact that she was so young, she already had established a boutique, and she was working on a lot of merch. The girl was constantly working. I mean, she was just the equivalent of a boss lady at that age. That she, to this day, she had been alive, she probably would have been billionaire status. She would have surpassed the Kardashians. Trust and believe. But yes, and this one was the most fun, but the most time consuming. Again, if you're gonna do this look, just take into consideration you're gonna need a whole like full Saturday, because that's how long it took me. And then the next day I put on these straps. So, but this was fun. It was a fun look to recreate. I really do suggest for you guys to see it. It is an incredible film. I'm also seeing at Cinemark also is playing this film. Again, you can Google this and look in your state where they're playing it. 25th anniversary, Jennifer Lopez and Edward James Olmos star an inspiring story of Selena Quintanilla, a girl from South Texas with global talent, incredible will, and magnetic charm, youth, beautiful and enormously gifted. Selena was the brightest star of the exploding Latin music scene, but just as she was poised to be the next pop music sensation, her life was tragically cut short. and recognition. Its enduring status in classic American film, Selena was inducted to the Library of Congress in 2021 National Film Registry. I did not know that. The film is 2 hours and 8 minutes long, and it is currently, and it's PG, perfect family viewing as well. And again, I also recommend you watching the series. It's 2 seasons. I think there are about 8 episodes apiece per season. And it gives you more background, and you'll also hear other songs that she also recorded. They weren't just the mainstream ones and the ones that made her popular, but also the Tejano songs that made her popular in Texas and especially in Mexico. So again, with that, y'all. Also, I want to make mention, if you're not familiar with T.S. Madison, I've known T.S. Madison for a number of years online. Very funny comedian. And has also been a part of, I believe, World of Wonder for a while. You know, she was working her own show, I believe, but it was closely related to, like, RuPaul's Drag Race, you know, fan base. So I remember, I'm sure maybe her videos are still up on YouTube, but the most recent one, this one in particular, it is up. But this one, that she was like the taxi driver, and she would always shed some light and some jokes, and one now she was kind of like working like almost like an Uber driver, but she was hysterical. And then seeing her now doing this was hysterical too. Like, bitty 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 bum bum. I thought that was the most funniest of things, and I'll link that in the description box below too. But yes, y'all, it is Selena season, and I can't wait. Let's see what drops. Maybe we'll hear new music, like the family is promising us fans, and we'll see. I will definitely keep you guys posted. Now, stay tuned. I got to review a number of other shows. I am really ecstatic to review the latest episode of Atlanta. We're going to get into that. But, ooh, was that a doozy? And a number of other films, too. Oh, and I've also been digging Moon Knight on Disney with Oscar Isaac. He's like my new crush, honey, because he is, oh. In that last episode, too, we're only in the second episode on Disney, but, ooh, ooh, a bare-chested Oscar Isaac. Oh, Lord have mercy. Honey, yo, you have to see it for yourself. But really, really great entertainment. I recommend it, too. And, yeah, stay tuned, y'all.
Cuando de repente me preguntó, ¿buscabas a mi hermano?
Not everybody knows that one. Again, you have to go through like all of her like famous songs, but I like those. I like the ones that not everybody knew, you know, can't really necessarily hum to. Those are really, really smart songs. So, no trivia. Not for nothing, too. She was popular when I was in high school, so I can't tell you, maybe because of my eyes, I'd always get the comparison to Selena. You know, who knows? I probably would have tried to, like, audition, but they wanted somebody known. So, again, not that I would ever. I would never put myself in that category where I thought that I could, but I do remember when the auditions were, like, rolling out and they were really looking for, you know, someone who was, like, her doppelganger or something, but they did. They did a great job in picking Jennifer Lopez. So, anywho, let's sign this off now. I just love this Lucy. I just feel like I don't even want to take this off.
Juntos los dos.
All right, y'all. Till next time, XOXO, Nitty Girls.